Hi, I'm Jaden from Newark, Delaware, and you're watching Fun for Louie. Yeah. Live the adventure. Boom.
Good morning, guys. It's just gone 6:30, and we are heading to the train station. And then I'm heading to London, and then getting the train to Paris. Should be fun. How you doing this morning, Dad?
I'm good.
Yeah,
but not. The sun isn't even up this morning yet.
Yeah,
it's before sunrise.
It's very early and very chilly. It's -1 degrees.
Ooh.
It's the hottest thing.
See you later, Dad. Thanks for the lift.
Bye.
Bye. All right, let's do this. This is my guy. 8:31, Paris. In the tunnel, we're heading towards France, so we're under the sea right now, which is kind of crazy. Does anyone know, is this one of the longest tunnels in the world? It must be, because it must be like 30 miles long or something. I'll show you a little map where we are. This is, I don't know if you can see this. This is England, and this is France, and we've already gone under here. So we're somewhere in the middle here, and then as soon as we get out the other side, we'll just be heading straight down towards Paris. Right, we are in France. I need to go about 30 minutes to get all the way to France from England. It's usually like 1.5 hours on the ferry.
Check this out.
Hello, France. This is a fast train. We're going 140 miles an hour.
Welcome to Paris, the local time is 11:49, and we will be arriving at Paris Gare du Nord where the train terminates.
Well, here I am, Paris, and what a beautiful day. This is nicer than London, definitely. And that was a very chilled, comfortable ride in the train. Definitely prefer it than flying. No hassle, you just step on, chill, you can walk around and then step off. No waiting, no faffing around in airports. I think I'll take the train more often when I'm just traveling into Europe. Right, I need to find my Uber. It's around here somewhere.
Found him.
Right, here I am. This is where my meeting is. So down there, Arc de Triomphe. Hello. Well, I finished my meeting and it went really well. I'll tell you about it when I can. Now I've got a few hours to kill in Paris and it's a beautiful day, so I think I'm gonna stroll down to the Eiffel Tower, chill out there. Don't know, really. I'm glad it's not that cold. Maybe I'll get a little coffee. I haven't been feeling fantastic today, guys. I felt a bit queasy this morning. I didn't feel great, but I feel better now. look, guys, I found the Eiffel Tower. Yes. I love watching these scam artists. They've obviously got a few friends working with them, and they're like showing other people that they're winning money, and then you guess where the ball is, and if you lose like 50 euros. It's a clever scam.
Hey, hey! Come on, clap! Clap! Come on, clap!
Right, I've come to the spot with the best view of the Eiffel Tower. It's looking pretty good. Welcome to Paris. Underneath the Eiffel Tower. It's pretty immense. I think I was here September 2013 with Nick. I think that's when I was last here. It's pretty epic, isn't it? Well, I decided not to go up the Eiffel Tower. I've been up a few times before. I am, however, quite hungry, so I'm gonna try and find somewhere not too expensive. I actually might go to the Sacre Coeur, which is another cool landmark of Paris. And you can like look over the whole of Paris from there, so I'm gonna see if I can make my way over there, maybe find a little coffee shop over in that direction.
He's just on the way.
These cars, guys. We had these cars growing up as a family. Citroen 2CVs. So cool. This is Sacre Coeur. I'm guessing it's a Catholic church from the looks of it. Check out these soldiers. They are not messing around. I've come into this cute little restaurant and I've ordered a pizza. I've got a coffee. I'm gonna chill here for a little bit because it's getting a little bit litty outside now. And I only had soup for lunch, so this should fill me up. Oh, I feel so much better after eating. I'm just gonna go for a little stroll now. I don't really know exactly where I am. I think I'm just gonna find some nice views because the sun has just set. Crazy, look, there's more soldiers just guarding the stairs. Nuts. I love the vibe of this little restaurant. colourful, chilled. It's very hard in Paris and any city, really, to in one day really explore it. So what tends to happen is you kind of just stick to the touristy areas, which is what I've done today: Eiffel Tower, Sacré-Cœur, and you don't necessarily get to see the real deep culture and a lot of what the locals experience. And you know, I think to do that, I need to stay a few more days, and I need to get some advice from the locals and some people that live in Paris, which I'd like to do one day. It's fun kind of wandering around on my own, but I bet I'm missing some amazing gems.
Again, I would like to ask you to use all the luggage storage areas available on board. You've got the overhead area above your seats for men.
We are leaving Paris. Look how luxury this is, guys. I couldn't really show this morning because there's a ton of people, but check this out. We've got a little area for laptop club. Just been served dinner. What's complimentary? And I'm just chilling. I'm just chilling with my desk. See you later, Paris. Right, back in London. That's definitely got to be one of the shortest trips abroad I've ever done. But it was good. It was a good amount of time to look around and obviously have the meeting. Now I just need to get a train back home. It's not even that late. It's like 10:30 or something. And my dad has kindly offered to come and pick me up. Well, this lamppost looks very cosy. Someone's knitted it a jumper. That's very kind. Well, I'm back home and I'm going to get some rest because tomorrow I'm flying to LA to go and hang out with a bunch of people. And then I'm heading up to San Francisco and then more adventures I'll tell you about. But I'll see you in the morning. Peace out. Enjoy life. And live the adventure. Boom.